pH of a solution. Actually, this is a scale at which is used to detect the strength of the acid or the strength of the base. pH means the potency of hydrogen. That means how much amount or how much concentration of hydronium ion present in the solution. Okay? So exact definition is what I am telling to you. The exact definition of pH is, you write down on your copy, the negative logarithm of concentration of hydronium ion in moles per liter. The negative logarithm of concentration of hydronium ion in moles per liter is known as pH. Okay, this is the way that how to calculate the pH of a solution, but this is not in your syllabus. How to find? Let's say I am giving you an example. If the hydronium ion in a solution is, let's say 1.0 into 10 to the power minus 5, this much moles per liter. What is the definition of pH? The negative logarithm of concentration of hydronium ion in moles per liter. Actually, concentration of any substance, if you find in a liquid substance, that is calculated in terms of moles per liter. Since these things are not in your syllabus, you just write the definition only. Maybe in practical classes they will ask to you. So you just remember the definition. After that, I am telling you how to calculate here. If you take the logarithm, since logarithm is not in CBSE syllabus, therefore these things are not needed. But just you know how to find the pH of any solution. 1.0 into 10 to the minus 5 means, if you take the logarithm of this, it will be negative logarithm, that means minus of log this thing. It will be minus of minus 5 log 10. Always log means this is base is 10. So it is plus 5. Two types of logarithm is there. One is natural, another one is Napier's logarithm. Normally, if base is not given, then base is taken as 10. Okay? So no need of remembering this. Simply you know what is the pH here. Here the just observe the exponent of the 10. This is 10 to the minus 5. If you take the negative logarithm, it will be 5. So here the pH is 5. Let's say 1.0 into 10 to the power minus 8 moles per liter. So what is the pH? That is 8. Like this, you can find the pH of any solution. This is plus 8. Let's say in 2 liter of water, the concentration of hydronium ion is 2.0 into 10 to the power minus 11. So what is the pH of this? In 2 liter this much means in 1 liter this will cut. So 10 to the minus 11. So pH is plus 11. It's okay. Like this you will calculate about the pH. pH scale is from 0 to 14. You just remember this. This is 7. So pH scale varies from 0 to 14. They have definite color. Here 14 means this is violet or blue. This is red. These are the instruments of the pH paper. So pH is 0 to 14. As your litmus paper, you know that all acids are changes blue litmus to red. Bases changes red litmus to blue. It's okay. That means In pH scale also, if pH is 0, that is red, pH is 14 means that part is violet, and the middle one, neutral part, it is green. So in between these, different colors are there. These are pink, here also blue to violet, like this, the colors are there. You just match the solution with the pH color, like that you will write which part it will coincide, you would write that. This part actually 0 to 7, these are the acidic parts mainly. Acidic strength goes on increasing this line. Acidic strength goes on increasing. And in this side, basic strength goes on increasing. It means what? pH 0 means strong acid, pH 14 means strong base, and 7 means it is neutral, it is green in color. So pH 0 to 7 means in between 0 to 7 these are acidic. As pH value goes on increasing, acidic strength goes on decreasing. After 7, if pH value goes on increasing, the basic strength goes on increasing. It means pH 0, 0.5, 1, 2, 6.3. That means strong acid, little bit less. So this is the strong acid, this is very much weak acid. Similarly, pH 7, after 7 to 14 means 7.5, 8, 10, 11, 14 means this is strong base, this is very weak base. So these are also weak bases. So basic strength goes on increasing means pH is 14. The maximum extreme end is 14. That means very highly strong basic. So in your book, if you notice that gastric juice has 1.2, that is HCl. Okay? Strong acidic is concentrated H2SO4, concentrated HNO3, these are strong, 0, 0.5 like this. Okay? And weak acid means all organic acids, citric acid, carbonic acid, etc., etc., they have pH between 3, 4 like this. Lemon juice has pH 2.2 like this. Okay? Similarly, milk of magnesia basic, that is pH is 10. MgOH whole 2, that is 10, like this the pH value here, 14 means it may be 13.5 or 14, and sodium hydroxide, caustic soda, potassium hydroxide, okay, like this, pH value, 14 means that is strong, okay. Now we'll discuss the importance of pH in everyday life, okay. So from your book, I will discuss one by one, you just remember what type of question will come from this part. Okay, one question in the exam will come that the pH is 3, 7, 8, 1, 14 like this. Identify the strong acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base, neutral like this. Okay, even if you know that distilled water, normally water is, water pH is 7. Pure water, very much pure water means that is maybe distilled water, that is very pure. But still then its pH never equals to 7. It is slightly acidic, 6.8 like that, 6.5 like this. That means, this, in case of distilled water, it may be absorb some carbon dioxide or maybe H plus ion. Little bit H plus ion will present, due to which it is little bit less. Pure water, not exactly 7, little bit less. Okay? Are plants and animals are pH sensitive or not? You know that in rain season, always it is raining means the normal water, okay? But after few days, let's say in summer or in winter, all of a sudden it will rain. That means in urban areas, the atmosphere mainly contains carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, etc. You know about all are acquainted with the acid rains, okay? Mainly in plant side area or urban area, the atmosphere contains carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, etc. So in rainwater, they get dissolved and produce acids mainly. And the rainwater containing this type of acid is known as acid rain. Let's say in a metallic container block, if you put some oil on it, let's say oil is there, and if you want to wash it with water directly, it will never wash properly. But in rain, if you put it, it will wash it. That means the water mainly contains acids. But where the acid is more, in a very long gap, if rain is there, that means that rainwater mainly contains acids. If it will fall on your body, it may cause skin irritation like this. Okay? Now we'll discuss from your book. All living organisms are mainly survive within the pH 7 to 7.8 because your blood mainly 7.8. Okay? pure blood is 7.4 in your book, it is given 7.4 means that means basic in nature. So any animal or plant mainly they survive with basic medium, not in acidic medium. So if acid rain is there, if the water's pH will get decreased to 5.6, something how like that, nearer to 5.6, in that case it is create problem to survive the aquatic plant or aquatic animal. That means you will notice that in the pond mainly the fishes get died or fishes have some disease, a part of their body will get destroyed like this. I have noticed in the pond, in 1 year I have noticed that in my student life. That means they get severe disease like this and part of our body will get destroyed. That means these are due to the acid rain, okay? So in acid rain, if the pH of the water is decreased below 5.6, that means it is create difficult to survive the aquatic plant or animal. So in this stage, what you will do? You will put either calcium hydroxide or limestone, etc. You will spread on the pond or in water if you are cultivating the fish in the pond, okay? That means you will raise the pH of the water, it's okay? In yellow box one is there, the atmosphere of Venus is mainly contain yellowish cloud, that means the vapor of sulfuric acid. So plants or animals cannot survive in Venus, it's okay? One question will come from this. Comes the next part, what is the pH of the soil in your backward? That means plant mainly survive in a particular pH. Which type of cultivation you are doing, which type of farming you are doing, which plant need or survive in at what pH, this thing you have to test the soil and report to the soil conservator officer or something like that. Like this you will plant properly, okay? Or otherwise if the pH is lower, you can increase the pH by adding calcium hydroxide or calcium carbonate, etc. You know that continuously using of chemical manure also decreases the pH of the soil. That means the soil will get hard, so some plants never get in the soil. So in that case you have to raise or increase the pH of the soil. pH in your digestive system, this thing is the most important part. In your stomach mainly HCl is secreted. So if you are taking the food, it mixes with the saliva and it that will neutralizes the HCl secret in your body. That means the food will get digested properly. If you are not taking the food, that means saliva is basic in nature. So it neutralizes the acid produced in your stomach. If you are not taking the food in proper time, in that case excess acid will get secreted. That acid may be, it is called as bile juice. Okay. So that acid, more amount of acid will form, means it will cause maybe acid vomiting or maybe peptic ulcer or like that it will form. Next part, pH changes the cause of tooth decay. In a human body, the teeth enamel, that is calcium phosphate, the teeth enamel, that is calcium phosphate, it is the hardest substance in the human body. Even if from your bones also, it is the hardest substance, that is calcium phosphate. But it is basic in nature. So it will get corrode or it will get dissolve or neutralize or react when the environment is acidic. So how the environment is acidic or how the your mouth is become acidic? When you take the food, maybe if and not washed properly, in that case the food particles remain in your mouth or remain in your gap of the teeth, they decompose by the bacteria and produce acid. If the acid or if the pH of the mouth will be below 5.5, in that case they corrode or decay the teeth. It's okay? They react with it, this is basic, and your mouth become acidic means it react with it or dissolve with it and cause tooth decay. That means after sleeping, you are sleeping 4 to 5 hours or 6 hours at night or in some cases 7 hours. So the food particles remain in your mouth, the mouth remain closed. That means they decompose by the bacteria and they decrease the pH of the teeth. If the decrease of the pH of the teeth is below 5.5, in that case it will cause tooth decay. So repeated number of times if you do the means, so the teeth will get decay and get corrode. That means it will create problem when you take the food, or it will make cause teeth pain. Okay, so it is advised to wash the teeth with a proper toothpaste, which is basic. We are using the toothpaste to increase the pH of our mouth. It is advised to wash properly 2 times in a day means, that means you have to increase the pH of your mouth, which prevent the tooth decay or tooth corrosion. Okay? Last part of the pH in your book, that is self-defense of animals. Okay? One plant is there, that is nettle string plant. If accidentally you touch the nettle string plant, it will cause irritation on your body. If accidentally you touch this type of plants, then it will cause skin irritation. Okay? Due to presence of methanoic acid in them, or if any honeybee or any creature, small insects, caught bite you, in that case what will happen? They inject methanoic acid into your body. So it will cause irritation. So don't do any different type of thing. Simply apply the basic substance, because that is acidic, due to which it will cause skin irritation, etc. Okay? So simply apply the basic substance. That means maybe toothpaste or maybe soap solution, any base is there in your home, or calcium carbonate solution is there. So take that and just use on the bite part, okay? Or accidentally if the plant will touch to you. How the animals get relief from that? At the place of nettle sting plant, nature provide another plant is there, that is dock plant, okay? Which is basic in nature, okay? So the animals get neutralized with dog plant and they get survived by this. Okay? Now come to the question part. Blue box question, page number 28. You have two solutions A and B. pH of solution A is 6 and pH of solution B is 8. Which solution has more hydrogen ion? That means the solution whose pH is low, it is strong acid, so it has hydrogen ion. More hydrogen ion, okay? Base means less amount of hydronium ion or hydrogen ion. So pH 6 has more hydrogen ion, whereas pH 8 has less. Which of these is acidic and which one is basic? pH 6 is acidic, pH 8 is basic. Question number 2, what effect does the concentration of H plus ion have on the nature of the solution? If more amount of H plus ion, it is more acidic, less amount of H plus ion, it is less acidic. Do basic solution have H plus ions? Yes, they have H plus ions. But then why they are known as base? You know that which one is strongly acidic, that means pH is 0, maximum amount of H plus ion is there, okay? Similarly, strong base means pH is 14, very least amount of H plus ion is there. As pH goes on decreasing, that means 11, 10, like this, that means here H plus ion is there. Also, but comparison to 14, it has less. Okay? But they are calling base because they have more amount of OH minus ion. It's okay? pH 7 means equal number of H plus ion and OH minus ions are there. Below 7 means maximum H plus ion there, OH minus ion is very minimum. But as you proceed forward, pH goes on increasing, it is strong basic, that means more amount of OH minus ion as compared to H plus ion. But absolutely OH minus ion is there, it is not possible. Okay? Number 4, under what soil condition do you think that the farmer would treat the soil of his field with quick lime or calcium hydroxide or slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide, or chalk, calcium carbonate? All these things are basic in nature. So if the pH of the soil is get decreased very much, in that case you have to add these type of things. Why the pH of the soil will get decreased very highly? That means due to excess use of chemical manure or one type of crops you are producing from the plant means, in that case also. So to increase the pH, we have to add this type of basic substance. It's okay?